And we're live. Tamriel Tuesday, it's back. Yes. We're back
for some more Morrowind.
Last time we had left off, I was getting started on the Lalu Hortator quest. And in the meantime, I have managed to finish that, and I finished the Telfani Hortator quest as well. So, yeah, that's taken care of. And, well, as you can see from my character, well, you can't really see it from here, but I'm wearing Daedric Greaves. I found a pair of Daedric Greaves in one of the places, so I'm wearing that. The quest now is basically to find the, talk to Vivek first, find the Sunder, find the Keening, and take them to Dagothur, the city of Dagothur, to defeat Dagothur, the person. It's confusing, I know. But hey, since we're here, let's talk about that asteroid again. So I did some reading up, and apparently, as it turns out, that used to be higher up. But during the second era, Vivek lost his power for a little bit, and it came crashing down for a little bit, and he managed to stop it right there. That's where it lives now. And as you know, before the events of Skyrim and after the events of the Oblivion Crisis from Oblivion, that hit the ground because Vivek disappeared. And people don't really know why Vivek disappeared because, well, of the actions of that our character can take in this particular game. You can kill Vivek. Technically. Or he can just go away and disappear and no one will ever hear from him again. So, canonically, that's kind of up in the air as to what happened. But yeah. Vivek, has the power to do that because he used Kangarnak's tools, the Sunder and the Keening, in the heart of Lorcan. Him, Almalexia, and Suthasil basically gave themselves godly powers, the Divine Spark, to, to make themselves gods. And as a part of the punishment for that, Almalexia went mad. Suthasil was, obsessed with the Heart of Lorcan and trying to create, like, his own version of it. And, of course, Vivek, along with the entire Chimer race, was given a darker skin, and the Chimer became the Dunmer. And Vivek, as we're about to see, is half and half. He has the golden skin of the Chimer and the dark skin of the Dunmer. Lord Vivek, the poet god king of Morrowind. Well, of Vardenfell, let's be honest. Because if Almalexia has anything to say, then that's, she is the one true goddess. And he's got plans for Dagothur and Nerevar at Red Mountain. Because Nerevar and Dagothur, back in the day, were, the two ones that didn't use Kangarnak's tools. Nerevar, either died or, I don't know if Dagothur killed him, but after the dwarves disappeared, Dagothur stayed with the Heart of Lorcan. You've got some eyes, dude. You've got some eyes. Yes! Expect for some more Morrowind. In any case, we gotta talk to Vivek, because he needs to give us the Wraithguard if we are to use the, the tools, the Keening and the Sunder. I expected you. We have business, you and I. Red Mountain. In my library, I have made available two conflicting accounts of the events of Red Mountain. My own true account and another false account common among the Ashlanders and preserved in the Apocrypha. I don't care whether you believe my account or not. I leave it up to you to judge which is true. There we go. And business. When I was young, like you, I was very impatient. So I will keep our business short. Then, later, there may be time for other things. First, I propose to remove my curse upon the Nerevarim, end the persecution of the dissident priests, and proclaim to all Morrowind that Pithero is the incarnate and Nerevarim, the prophesied savior of Morrowind. And the last hope to withstand the madness of Dagathur and the Sixth House. These things I will do, whether you wish it or not. How nice of you. Next, I propose to surrender to you the power and responsibility of defeating Dagathur. You may choose to refuse. I will not compel you. You will receive the power as a gift in the form of an artifact called the Wraith Guard. You may accept the gift, then do with it as you will. You will receive the responsibility as an oath. You may give your oath, then keep it or break it as you like. First, you will accept Wraith Guard as a gift. Yes, I will accept Wraith Guard. Good, sensible of you. And now, I will give you your oath. Before all gods and men, before all spirits visible and invisible, before my honor and your honor, to dedicate yourself and Wraithgar to defeat the defeat and destruction of Dagathur and the preservation of Morrowind and his people. Yes, I so swear. Not very sensible, but very good. I was hoping someone who would have no hesitations about making such an oath. You will now have a brief momentary sensation of time passing. Don't be alarmed, you are being taken out of time in order to avoid the unpleasant experience of learning how to use Wraith Guard. It will be over before there is a brief sensation of motion in total darkness, floating without a sense of weight or direction. You know it. Now, I will notify the temple that you are our champion. There shall be no more persecution of the dissident priests, and I hope both sides shall swiftly be reconciled. We have time for questions, if you like, or you may leave as you wish. But I think there are at least two things you ought to know. How to use Wraith Guard, and how to defeat Dagathur. How do I defeat Dagathur, then? To defeat Dagathur, go to Red Mountain to recover the artifact Hammer Sunder from Gate Citadel Venomal. I wanted to say Venomal, but whatever. Then recover the Artifact Blade Keening from Gate Citadel Udrasol. Then proceed with Wraith Guard, Sunder, and Keening to the Citadel of Dagathur. Within the Citadel, find the Heart of Lorcan. Use the three artifacts to sever Dagathur's connection to the Heart, and he will be destroyed. And the Blight ended on Morrowind. And how do we do that? To destroy Dagathur, you must sever his connection with the Heart of Lorcan. To do this, strike the Heart with the Artifact Hammer once. Then strike the Heart more than once with the Artifact Blade Keening. You must wear Wraith Guard, because you cannot handle either Sunder or Keening unless you are wearing Wraith Guard. That is the short, simple explanation. Here is the long, detailed explanation, written down for your convenience. Read it, study it, commit it to memory. Okay, that's the plan to defeat Dagathur. And the Council. You need to know where is Dagathur, what are Dagathur's plans, who are Dagathur's servants, who is Dagathur, what are Dagathur's powers, and what is known about Dagathur's defenses. How can I prepare for battle against Dagathur? Who can help? Okay, those are all conveniently highlighted. Let's go. Where is he? He's never ventured out of the Heart Chamber, place under Red Mountain where the Heart of Lorcan lies. It is there, or nearby, that he is constructing a new god, Akulakan, also known as the Second Numidium. And his plans? His plans, we know nothing for sure, but we have learned much. From interrogating Six House cultists and victims of dream compulsions, and from our study of Dagathur's actions, the temple scholars and inquisitors have prepared a document. It summarizes what we know or suspect. Take this copy, it's also available in my library. Right on. So, servants. Chief among his servants are his seven brothers, the Ash Vampires. Powerful heart whites. racist, and cunning sorcerers of old. These creatures appear to die, but always are revived at the heart. Somehow, Dagather has conferred some portion of his immortality upon them. Or perhaps they sustain themselves through more conventional sorcery. And who's he? He is the former leader, Lord High Counselor of House Dagoth. Makes sense. He was Lord of Lord Nerevar's generation, older than we, and a mighty sorcerer and enchanted in life. In his sustained shadow immortality, he appears to be highly intelligent, severely deluded immortal monster with unparalleled supernatural abilities. And we're going up against him. Good times. He appears by turns, lucid and deranged, compassionate and bestial, profoundly wise and profoundly disordered. In short, he is a mad god. Sheogorath would like a word. A word, that is. His powers. He's able to send his mind into the dreams of susceptible victims across vast distances. The victims are either swayed by his compulsions or driven mad. He also seems nearly invulnerable to physical and magical harm. His flesh, and the flesh of his followers, evolves towards a mutable, magical form. Ooh. Jill, that's disgusting. Dagather in the highest ranks can control the distorted manifestations of their flesh. Lower ranks lose controls of their bodies and become mindless corpus monsters. Well, now we know where corpus came from. Again. Dagather's defense, how can I prepare for battle? Prepare for war. Beyond the ghost fence, there are no safe places, no allies. Stockpile resources, plan for retreat and replenishment. Quest for artifacts of power. Alright, so I don't want help. And the reason I don't want help is because I'm going to try and kill him. Since he's already given me the Wraith Guard. Look at it. Look at that thing. Resist shock, resist fire, resist frost, resist magic, and resist poison. Shield 10 points, and reflect 20%. And we have this glow permanently around us. Yeah, that's gonna get annoying. And we also lose the thing that gives us strength, which is annoying. Put that back on. In any case, I'm gonna see if I can paralyze him. Alright, in 3, 2, 1. I can't. He resists the magic. I also don't want to get hit by whatever the hell he's sending my way. And he has a shit ton of magicka, so that might be a while. He hit me. Okay, so he's very invulnerable to paralyzation. I'm gonna try again. And he sounds like a... ash vampire. Or a werewolf, I guess. Doing this for a while. It might still be able to kill me in melee for all I know. Which is very likely. He is the god king. Come on. I want the left-handed Wraith Guard as well. Come on. Those spells deal way too much damage for you to be casting them non-stop. Please. Come on. Shit, I got hit again. Never mind. We can kill him. I'll come back later and try to do that. In any case. So with that particular event out of the way, you see those stairs there? They go into the puzzle canal. And there's a couple of, puzzles in there that you will need to solve in order to unlock some treasure. Honestly, I can't remember what the treasure is, so it's probably not particularly relevant. In any case, that, the fact that I have to lose my strength gauntlet means that I have to shed a shedload of weight. Which means I'm gonna go make a stop at Balmora. I just need to find a boat. I could have used the boat from the temple. That would have been faster, wouldn't it? Anywho. We shall go and take this boat to just outside of town. And then take the Siltstrider to Balmora. And I shall leave some stuff, like the shield, because Illidan's ward is very good, but it's very heavy. And I use a two-handed weapon, so I can't really, you know, use it properly. Anywho, the Siltstrider is over there. And yeah, it's from here is a straight shot up to the ghost fence, and from the ghost fence into the places. The place is what we need to go to. That's a dreamer.
Why walk when you can run?
And he'll attack me if I go close now, I think, because I'm a friend of the temple. They didn't mind me much when I was, when the temple didn't like me. But now they do. And here's my house. I already dropped some stuff like the Umbra Sword and the Daedric Daikatana. Now, I'm going to drop the Retort, the Calcinator, and, the Alembic, and the Mortar and Pestle. And the Bug Musk, and the Daedra Heart, and Restore Health I shall keep, Restore Fatigue I shall keep, Invisibility, might as well. Don't need the Water Breathing. Breathing? Breathing. Breathing. The. There. And the Red Book, don't need that no more. Saint Nerevar, don't need that. Don't need the Yellow Book either. See what else? Shishi report? Nope. Lost prophecy. Pature. You know what? Y'all go on the floor. I don't remember it doing this. If you did that, I guess that's an improvement that OpenMW's already made. I should probably drop the scrolls too, huh? Anywho, the Underworld helmet. Because everyone knows I'm Nerevar now, so I don't need to pretend to be. And I can't use it to kill ordinators anymore, so... Marm. Igathur is powerful, Vivek is blue, oh no, subscribe jelly on my shoe. A very good... John the Holy Crusader, very good. Let's see. I will keep the Chrysomere. The Daedric Crescent. I think Dagathur is immune to paralysis, so I'm kind of tempted to just drop it. Then again, his friends might be a bit more into that kind of stuff. I can leave that amulet. I'll leave the boots. They have served me well. The Steel Blade of Heaven is very good to have, just because levitation. And the Moravane Ash statue. Let's put that right there, because that's particularly heavy. Go figure. The coins. There's a lot of coins. Yes, let's go to the table here and put the things. I shall keep the one with the golden saints, or the two with the golden saints. And what else? Them all, I'm not capturing souls right now, so I need all the weight I can get. Why do I have a pillow? Seriously, where did I get that pillow? let's see. That might be useful to recharge. I don't want to use them to recharge, so let's take... If we'll take one of these, or a couple of these smaller ones to recharge our weapons if need be. I did already stop at the shop to repair them, so... Yay for planning ahead, sort of, kind of. Restore fatigue for 120 points. Might need to use one of those. Meh, we'll take the scrolls. Let's see, we have 400 pounds. 400 pounds. Yes, I know, right? Who do I think I am coming in here and planning ahead my own stream? Alright, so... From Aldrun, we can see the ghost fence, and the Odrosal is there. Viminal is there. And the ghost gate is down here. So we'll just walk to the ghost gate. That way. Basically keep walking that way. Alright. I think I'm already at 100, 100 acrobatics, because jumping is faster than running. All that bunny hopping in the 90s. Turns out there was some truth to that. How about you there, Cliff Racer? Yes. Okay. Chris Amer in hand, because I'm not doing the Imperial Legion quests just yet. Although I may do them, but not on stream. I think after I finish the main quest itself, it's gonna be that for Morrowind. I mean, this. The goal here was to sort of kind of prove that, yes, you can play all the way through the main campaign with OpenMW. And you can. Oh, you can hear the humming of the ghost fence. Anywho, what I need is that levitation dagger. Because I can't cast Wild Levitate yet. Oh, that doesn't have enough charge, does it? Nope. And I can't rest while there are enemies nearby. Annoying. Okay. Apparently we're floating all the way to Odrosal. Because I'm about to use the Windwalker. Whee! We're flying! We're flying pretty damn fast. Where is it? There. That one. Let's put the Chrysomere back in our hands. Alright. That's all that I saw. I think. Yes, it is. Very good. Oh, that's a golden saint. Ah, I didn't bring the Umbra. Oh. Oh, hello, not Degathur. Dagoth Odros. What do you have, Dagoth Odros? The Six House Amulet, yes, it's good for selling. The Amulet of Heartfire. I was putting an H where there wasn't any. That fortifies a bunch of things. I shall take it. And I shall take your key. And the Ash Salts. And the amulet. Right. The dead dreamer. Well, that scroll of Windwalker has faded now, so we're walking at our regular speed. I can open doors. Where's the spell to do so? Well, I can. If the spell doesn't fail a lot. Dwarven claymore. Axe. What's in the chest? Ooh, coins. I don't know why I'm bothering, but I am. So, mind me. Right. Quiros. Nice. Fortify agility. Frost shield. Another spear. Oh, how did I... Seriously, I have the key. Yeah. I am a dummy. I have the key. I don't need to be... Oh, God. Whatever. Hello there, Miss Golden Saint. Down you go, and you're dead. She has the Shield of Wounds and the Glass Jinx Blade. Oh, that paralyzes on touch. Can't have that. Those are annoying. Another dead dreamer. Okay, so I'm in Odrosol. What am I missing? The Sunder should be here. Or the Keening. Either or, really. There's a potion. Ah! I need to levitate. Okay. Thanks, game. Look at that particular bit of game design right there. Whee! And we're up here. If there's nothing up here, I'ma be mad. Dwarven Mace, Dwarven Warhammer. Master's Armor Hammer. That's good for repairing and stuff. Oh, it's good for repairing stuff. Ornate Dwemer Chest. Ornate Dwemer Chest. Dwarven Boots. Dwarven Greaves. Where's the Sunder? Yo? Where's the Keening? That's not cool. I thought I was being real clever by, you know, finding the potion. I'm missing something. I have to be missing something. Okay. There. Oh. Yes. That's what I'm missing. Hello, Keening. Come to daddy. Fortify Magicka, 50 points. Fortify Health, 30 points. Fortify Attack, 30 points. Fortify Attribute, Agility, 20 points. Fortify Attribute, Speed, 20 points. I have the Keening. There it is. And we're a bit faster, and it's a dagger that I can actually use and hit things with it, which is nice. You're right. Okay. It doesn't deal a whole lot of damage. But anywho, let's see. Now we have to go all the way around to Viminal. So, to Viminal we go, and I'm going to take both the Keening and the Wraithgar out of my hands, because that glowy glimmer constantly around me is a bit annoying. It's very good, you know, to have permanent shield, but it's annoying. Hello there. You cast a little too fast. Oh, come on, really? Well, they won't let me go up here. So, since I can't cast a wild levitate, I'm gonna rest. Hopefully those 5 hours have given my Blade of Heaven enough charge. No, then we shall rest for 24 hours. Okay. Now we have enough charge. Let's see. Well, that is taking us straight to Degathur. And to that lame corpus. Which died in one hit. Man, this sword is amazing. That's a funky looking Daedra. That's called hunger. Alright, so since we wanna go down into the boiler of this particular volcano, I was going to try and go around the side here so I could get around the thing. And I'm going to have to wait a bit more. The item does not have enough charge. God damn it, come on. Okay, it has enough charge now, but that mouse spawned in an awkward place. Right. Where am I going? Over there, there. See if we can get up high as we'll go. And I think we're at the highest point in Morrowind right now. What is that place? Haven't been there yet. But that is a place for me to discover on my own. And there's another cliff racer. There's a ghost fence. There's some Daedric ruins down there. But I am looking for, I think it's that city over there. Yes, looks like it. It's amazing how these things manage to be annoying right up until the end of the game. So, from here, what saw me? Was it you? No, something else seen me. Was it you? I think it might have been the mouse. Oh no, it was this one. Alright. I waited too long to hit him. Alright, so the city is there. It's a gate city, whatever that means. That's what Vivek called it anyway. Right. So many damn cliff racers. Hello there, Corpora Stalker. Give me a hug. He did. Alright. Can't rest here. Can rest here. Just a few hours. So we can have our health back. That's a bone walker. Stop draining my strength. God damn it. No. God damn it, it drained even more this time around. Hellfire on target. Good. He dies. Okay. That's the one stupid freaking creature that I refuse to fight head on is those large bone stalkers because they train my strength. And I need my strength to swing my sword. Yeah, you heard me. and you should have died, Dagoth Nilor. If that is your real name. Some arrows. Some stuff with things. Scrap metal. Dwarven short sword, right? So I guess this one is not going to be as simple as the other one. May have to do some searching for the Sunder, or it's probably right down there for all I know. Anywho, the Bone Walker was around here. What's around here? Hello! We have Cthulhu over here, Dagoth Garel. Garel? It only has the one L, so Garel it is. And the coin. I don't know why I'm bothering, but it's just force of habit. I see a coin, I gotta take it. That's why I deliberately left that one there. Hello, Ash Zombie. Well, I hit him so hard, I broke his animation. Anywho. Lots of things that would be useful in other situations. Parchment with scrolling. Scrawlings, yes. All cries are waking. Whitest white of all white races. Blackest black of all okay, no. Shape and sun and shadow. Was stronger than gods, brighter than mortals. Only he is awake, only he is alive. He knows the names and naming. He knows the wait and the waiting. He enters into every star and moon. He shines through their shadows. One shape, one spelling, one wraith, one casting. There's probably a melody that goes with this. I don't know what it is. From darkness he is armed. From light he is warded. He is all things. Drake, Lich, Theoman. On rivers he comes forth. Oh no, I remember this. I read this. Yes. I see it with my eye. And all is silence. I wake. I remember. Lord! For the grace, for the might of our Lord. Oh, look, it's the Grandmaster's Alembic. I'll take that. That's better than the one we left behind. In Balmora. Chameleon, detect animal, slow fall, fortify attribute, speed. The Hole of Torque. I kind of rushed in here, not even looking at what I was doing. That was ballsy. Anywho. We shall heal. Fine, be that way. I'll take that. And... did you have anything? No. Well, I think, oh, that's Dagoth not And he really seems to like that door, in particular. Cool. Hello there, Mr. Drebra. You are a Drebra Lord, because of all that HP. Okay. And since what's his name is down there, we can't rest here, so we shall go down there and meet him, and probably die in the process. By my luck. Mostly because we have another ash vampire thing. What are these things? They look like anteaters. Ash and Eaters. Yes, let's go with that. Oh, hello there, Mr. Skeleton Champion. Were you going to cast a spell on me? Blood Feet Shield. Oh, it absorbs health. That's what it was going to try and do to me. Okay, right on. Okay, gotcha. Now there are still enemies nearby. What if we go right on the corner there? No. Worth a shot. Restore fatigue. And the potion does its thing. We got our fatigue. Dagoth, not Ur. Dagoth, Femin. The amulet of Hearth's heart heal. Oh god, that's hard to say. And the Sunder. He was carrying the Sunder. Give me. Oh, this one's got levitate. Cool. Cool, 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 cool. So we have both the Sunder and the Keening. We have the tools. So hit the heart with the Sunder once, and with the Keening more than once. That's what we need to do to destroy the Heart of Lorik. Well, not destroy, because the Heart of Lorikon is the last remain that saw Nern of the god Lorikon. When Lorikon itself existed in the world, Grandmaster Calcinator. Yeah, I'll take that too. Do you have the rest of him? No. Yeah, guess not. But yeah, when he existed in the world, his body was cleaved by the other gods that existed at the same time, and part of his flesh became one of the moons, the other part became the other moon, and his heart, where it fell, in Nern, well, Red Mountain sprung up from it, and then the city of Dagothur sprung up around it, because the dwarves were like, ooh, this is a very powerful artifact. We kind of want it. So they built a city around it. Right in the crater of the volcano. If they hadn't screwed with powers beyond their imagining and basically been erased from the material plane of existence, I think the volcano would have just killed them. Like, that was pretty much unavoidable. For the Wemmer, anyway. As for us, well, there's no much, there is, let's try that sentence again. There is no point in avoiding it, anymore. Because we're here, and we might as well get it over with. So let's go and, kick Dagothur's shit in. Why won't we? And they let us heal, which is nice. Let's see. If we keep going this way, we'll basically end up exactly where the marker is, so we're gonna keep going this way. And you know what? Except for those weird freezing issues that it had for a while after I cranked the draw distance up a little too high, OpenMW is very much the best way to play Morrowind, right now. Unless you really want to use those mods. Which, until they make a mod that completely overhauls the combat, like they did that one for Skyrim, where they basically made combat more like Sekiro, which is amazing. I want that. I freaking want that so much, you have no idea. Yeah, I'd totally use a mod like that for Morrowind, absolutely. And something to revamp the animations of the characters as well. That too would be nice. Where's the one that had levitate? There. And levitate we shall. Just because I know the power of levitation, despite, and this is a little bit of trivia, during the time that Morrowind takes place, the levitation spells were forbidden in the Empire. Since Morrowind was basically self-ruling, the Empire didn't really care that they were using, and, well, especially the Telvanni wizards, we're using spells of levitation. It's like, yeah, you guys are self-ruling, so you do you, we'll leave you alone. And, well, there it is. The big fire of red. No. We will not slide all the way down there. Thank you very much. So, is Digather gonna let us in? Well, someone's seen me. I suppose we have to find a crank, which is right here. And something's seen me. Not that I can see what it is, but whatevs. Oh, man. I need telekinesis. I need telekinesis or find another way in. How the hell do I get in there? Alright. Come on, quickly! There we go. Ooh. It's just gotta be fast.
Come, Nerevar, friend or traitor, come. Come and look upon the heart and a Kulakan. And bring Wraithguard. I have need of it.
Well, wouldn't you know it? Dagathur, he speaks. He's got voice acting. What up? The Gene Machine 1. Welcome. We're right at the end. It's now or never. Or
come to the
something.
Heart Chamber. I wait for you there where we last met countless ages ago.
And he speaks again. Hello, Cthulhu. Dang it. I wanted to avoid the poison. Alright. Please stop hurting me. I'm going to need that health. Alright, I should actually rest. If I could find a place to rest in here. Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy reference? Yes. Right. Cool. Anyone else who wants to tango before I get down to the business? Well, I guess he wanted to tango, but he decided to go on ahead without me, so he can do whatever it is that he wants to do.
Come to me through fire and war. I welcome you.
I know that voice. I know that voice. And I know that voice because Bethesda's games have... They all have the same three voice actors. And the same three voice actresses. The hell's that? An elf boot? Aye? Cure poison, that might be useful. These all seem to have the same thing, which is all rather pointless. The inner facility, whatever that means. Hello.
Welcome, Moon and Star. I have prepared a place for you.
Of course you have. That's just fire, and I came very close to the edge there. Feather. No. Okay. And if I'm not mistaken, he's down that way, so. Hello there, Mr. Corpora Stalker. Or I may be mistaken, maybe it's that way. I do not know. Anywho, there's a bow here. An enchanted bow. The demon longbow. Which means you can summon... Ooh, and the master's probe. I'll take that. Telvanni Dust Adept Helm. Dust Adept. Tell me that's not a reference.
Bring Wraithguard to the Heart Chamber. Together let us free the cursed false gods.
That poison, though. You're gonna run out of magic at some point. There we go. Oh shit, he paralyzed me. He still had enough magicka to paralyze me. Moon and Star. Nerevar. That's a bone walker, isn't it? Hello, dead hero. Oh. This dead hero was a vampire. Blood Feet Shield and Demon Mace. Yes. We already have a Demon Mace. I don't want to go tango with a Bone Walker. I really don't. Really don't. Imperial Dragon Scale Helm! How about that? It's medium. Don't care. There's actually a tomb somewhere in the game hidden behind several locked doors. That's the Master's Alembic. We already have one of them. Apprentice's Retort. No. Right. I hit it right in the arm. And we shall rest until healed.
Welcome, Nerevar. Together we shall speak for the law and the land and shall drive the mongrel dogs of the Empire from Morrowind.
You do know that the temple was all up in arms because I was a member of the Blades? Because I am a spy for the Empire? Technically speaking. Hello. You're not Dagathir. You're too early to be Dagathir. No. I don't even know how much damage that thing deals, so... Are you gonna come at me? I thought he was going to walk right into the pit of lava. That would have been... Oh, I'm sorry. I was saying... Dagoth Gilvoth. Not prized for his, smarts. That one. Let's just put him out of his misery. And, let's see. Does the blade... Oh, it does. How about that? So I can go here and loot his corpse. The blood ring. Give me. Right.
Is this how you honor the sixth house and the tribe unmourned? Come to me openly, and not by stealth.
Oh, a Daedric short sword. How about that? This person was well equipped. I shouldn't have done that, but I'll drop it if need be. It's just a little too pricey for me to just leave behind. Oh, there he is. There's Dagathir. Right. So I'm pretty sure that's already more weight than I'll be able to carry once I equip this thing. Yes, yes it is. Drop the Daedric short sword, please. Thank you. Okay. Right, Dagathir.
Welcome, Moon and Star, to this place where destiny is made.
Who do you voice? Who do you voice in Fallout 3? That's what where I know that voice from. Dagather. Isn't he pretty? Anywho. It began here. It will end here. Have you any parting words? Or would you prefer skip the speeches and get to our business? You are the challenger here, after all. So, to you goes a courtesy of the first blow. Parting words. Now that you have come to me here, there can be but one result. Many times I have considered offering to share this place with you. I considered offering to accept your oath of service. You might even try to buy my trust by giving me Wraithguard Keening and Sunder. I thought we might once again be friends, comrades, brothers in arms. But I have won this place, and power by right of conquest, by right of daring and enterprise. I will not risk it to cunning and deceit. I offer you no deals. You are my enemy. I cannot trust you. And even if you are not my enemy, I cannot let you live. It will all be decided here. I will prevail, but I cannot be sure. And I am vain enough that, should I fall, I would wish to be remembered in my own words. So, if you have final questions you would ask them now. I have final questions to ask you, if you would answer. Right, ask me then. My first question is, are you really Nerevar reborn? I'm a self-willed hero, and I make my own fate. You are bold. I honor your independence. You are one to teach the gods their limits. I hope the bards will praise the glory of your death in song. My second question is, if you win, what do you plan to do with the power from the heart? Will you make yourself a god, establish a thearchy, or will you complete a Kulakan and disrupt control of Tamriel with the Septims? Or will you share the heart with your followers, as I have, and breed a new race of divine immortals? Yeah. I will do no such thing. I have my own secret plan for the heart. Perhaps there may be surprises in store for me yet, or perhaps you obscure your plans on principle, or perhaps you are an instinctive bluffer. No matter. My final question is, if I had offered you to let you join me, would you have surrendered Wraithguard Sunder and Keening to me to seal your oath? No, I would never surrender the tools. No, I would... Honestly, considering how powerful they are, yeah, no, I would never surrender the tools. An interesting response. You might have been willing to join me, but never to surrender the tools. Very interesting. I'm glad I didn't try to bargain with you. And now, if you have any questions, ask them. Otherwise, you are the challenger. I wait your first blow. Ask question. Alright, we're asking the questions then. What is your plan for the heart? Continue to draw divine power from the heart and distribute it to my kin and followers. I will continue to broadcast divine power upon the Blight Winds, so that it will touch each soul in Vardenfell. Cool. The sixth house will serve as the elite cadre of our movement. As cultists evolve through various stages of enlightenment, they will become as suits their abilities, either holy warriors or priests. Their duty is to prepare themselves for service. Okay. See, what is your plan for the Dunmer? I will free the Dunmer from the Imperial yoke and cast down the false gods of the temple. Alright. Let's see, how do you justify your crimes? If by my crimes you mean the inevitable suffering and destruction caused by war, then I accept the burden of leadership. Well, aren't we a tyrant? What happened to the Dwemer? I have no idea what happened to the Dwemer. I have been denied the opportunity to study Wraithguard, and I am not sure how much of Kangarnak's lore was invested in his tools. How much in his own sorcery and mastery. I have long studied Kangarnak, and have come to admire his wisdom and craft. Someday, after the campaigns of the Sixth House are secure, I hope to have time to dedicate to this mystery. I'm finished talking. Defend yourself. Very well. If you are impatient to begin, go ahead. You are the challenger. To you goes the first blow. Okay. Well, that's not fair. You said the first blow was going to me. You ginormous prick. That dealt a lot of damage. I better not let him do that to me again. Right. This is it. This is it. So, once with the keening, more than once with the sunder. Oh, hello. It's a heart ring. Another heart ring. How kind of him. A Kula Khan's chamber.
I'm a god. How can you kill a god? What a grand and intoxicating innocence. How could you be so naive? There is no escape. No recall or intervention can work in this place. Come, lay
no
down
intervention.
Your weapons.
Right on.
It is not too late for my mercy.
No. Where's the 60 seconds on self? Yep. We shall restore our vitality. Holy crap! Did you see the amount of damage that thing dealt to me? Shit. That damn nearly killed me. Okay, I'm gonna use one of them potions, because it's faster, and one of them. And I'm gonna keep running. That one up ahead spotted me. These dreamer workers are way too powerful. So, last time I went through this fight with Dagathur, he fell into lava and I couldn't loot his corpse. I'm not joking. Did he see me? I guess he saw me. Or something saw me. Well, the Heart of Lorcan is up ahead. So, let's put an end to this. He was, in fact, building the Akula Khan. The god machine that the, Dwemer started, but never finished. I hear that. Okay, I hit it with the keening once and with the hammer twice. Or was it the other way around? I don't remember.
What are you doing?
Get up! Get up! I'm gonna die. Okay, I need a lot of healing, and I have a scroll for that. If I can get up. Alright, come on. I'll have to go back and sunder the heart at some point, but I'm over encumbered. You dick! You've been draining my stuff. Okay, since I'm not... You're gonna run out of magicka at some point. Yeah, no, I straight up can't damage him. Alright. And the... I'm out of the really good ones. God damn it.
And 200 points. All right, that'll do it. Put the thing on. Please stop damaging me. why can't I kill the goddamn heart? I'm over encumbered. I am out of strength, out of the ability to move, and god damn it.
What are you, fool? Stop!
This is the end. The bitter, bitter end.
There it goes. Okay, there goes the heart. He dies. Oh, it doesn't have anything. Oh well. That's it. That's the end of Dagathur. The heart of Lorcan isn't even here anymore. So now what? I thought we'd get the ending cutscene, like, right now. Oh, I suppose they wanted us to do that. The Akula Khan is destroyed. What else? What else happens? Azura? Anyone? Now's the time. Come on, chop chop. Let's see, what do we have here? The Sunder is draining my fatigue for 0 points because I'm wearing the Wraith Guard. Yep. Nerevar, Moon and Star. Killer of Gods. I guess we just go back. Not many other alternatives seem to present themselves to us. Further down, there is... some mining carts. There doesn't seem to be anything down there, and... yeah. I guess this is just like an area you could have kited Dagathur to if you needed to go back into the bridge. But yeah, I'm just gonna load that quick save I did up here. Right. The door is closed. Why is the door closed? There's the handle. Crank. Crank it. There is a distinct lack of, there she is. There's Azura. I thought she actually, spawned in the other room, but... Alright. Hi.
Bear the burden of prophecy. You have achieved your destiny. You are free. The doomed Duemer's folly. Lord Dagoth's temptation. The Tribunal's seduction. The God's heart freed, the prophecy fulfilled. All fate sealed and sins redeemed. If you have pity, mourn the lost. But let the weeping cease. The blight is gone, and the sun's golden honey gilds the land. Hail, Savior, Hortator, and Nerevarine. Your people look to you for protection. Monster and villains, great and small, still threaten the people of Vardenfell. Enemies and evils abound, yet indomitable will might rid Morrowind of all its ills. For you, our thanks and blessing, our gift and token given. Come, take this thing from the hand of God.
And this thing is her ring. Her actual ring. One of the rarest Daedric artifacts. And here's that Daedric short sword I dropped earlier. That's fine. I'll take it now. There it is. The end. Thank you for 20 whole episodes of basically blitzing through the main quest. Except for right at the beginning. There had to be a little bit of detours because the game so demands it. But that's it. That's the end of Morrowind. Well, the main campaign anyway. I might do more at some point. I can't hit it. But yeah, I will probably stream something else next Tuesday. Maybe start a new big game to keep me going for the things. Might do the DLC, might not. Probably not. But yeah, you'll know next week, mostly because I have no idea yet. In any case, thank you all very much for joining me for 20 whole episodes of about an hour each of this particular train wreck. It had its share of mishaps. It had its share of interruptions. It had a great deal many things. But for me, it was more of an excuse to play a game I really like. So I might continue to do that. With this game, with a different game, who knows? There's a Dwemer statue. And the Corpus, Lame Corpus. Put the nice glove back on, thank you. Right. That's it. Red Mountain is no longer blighted. The ghost fence is, well, it's now even more useless than it used to be. I have. Oh no, they straight up turned it off. They turned off the ghost fence. That's impressive. A little bit unnecessary, but impressive nonetheless. So yes. That's it. That's the end. Thank you all, and don't forget to tune in tomorrow for Linux Weekly Daily Wednesdays. With myself, Jill, and Ven. There's Jordan is coming back on Thursday to do more of his streams. Ven will be doing the Friday Night FUBAR, and of course, Saturday. It's the, it's the big show. Linux Gamecast Weekly. So, stick around. Whole week's worth of Linux content ahead of you. And it's only just begun. Peace.